friends. Welcome back to the Creative Discovery Museum. My name's Haven and I'm a museum educator here. Today we will be doing marshmallow science and we're gonna need a couple things. So we'll need some Rice Krispies, a bag of marshmallows, butter, skewers, measuring cup, a campfire of sorts, and we'll talk more about that later, a pot for melting and cooking, a spoon to stir, and then a couple things that we'll ask our parents to help us with. We'll need a lighter and then a knife. How many of you have ever toasted a marshmallow? Did you notice anything about it as it started to heat up? Maybe the color changed from white to brown or black? Today we're going to explore why marshmallows react the way they do when heated. So our campfire here is what we're gonna use to toast our marshmallow, but if you do not have one of these at home, you can also take a clay pot, some aluminum foil and charcoal to light, or you can put your marshmallows in the oven and let them broil for a little bit. Since we're going to be using our campfire, we need to make sure our parent is close by with the lighter. And a couple of safety tips before we get started. You wanna make sure that your hair, clothes, and hands are back away so they don't get burnt. Now, if you have your skewer, this is when we're gonna use this, or you can use campfire sticks, those work too. You have them handy. And we're just gonna hold this over for a couple seconds. So if we look at it, what do you notice that has changed? It's definitely gooey now, and the color has again changed to brown and black on the parts where it's a little crispy. You can see that it is definitely expanded. As the air molecules heat up, they expand and they grow. The marshmallow on the outside where we had toasted it remained a little bit firm, but you can see the inside's still pretty gooey and it's all very sticky. That wasn't happening beforehand. We can also see that the color changed as it started to caramelize. Caramelization is a chemical reaction of the sucrose being heated and breaking down into fructose and glucose. Now let's taste it. It's very sweet and now it's got a little hint of toasty flavor. But let's do one more experiment with our marshmallows and make a classic treat called Rice Krispie Treats. All right, in your pot, you're gonna put in 3 tablespoons of butter. And if you look on the stick, you can see where the measurement's already laid out. So it's a really easy cut to make. And then we're gonna let this finish melting and add in our bag of marshmallows. All right, so we're gonna make sure and stir our marshmallows during this process so they melt down evenly. You're gonna wanna put your stove on medium heat during this process. Finish stirring our Rice Krispies and the marshmallows together. You're going to want to butter the pan that you're going to choose to put in. We're using this one right here. And then I'm going to put a little butter on my hands so that they don't stick. When I'm forming the shapes. Down all the way, you can use your hands, but mine's still a little warm. So I'm going to start with this. There we go. So now we'll just let them sit for a little bit and then our Rice Krispies treats will be ready. Hope you guys learned some things about marshmallow science. I know I did, and we'll see you next time. Bye.